So today I'm going to show you how to make your own stickers, custom stickers. You can buy them either in strip form, like so, or you can buy them in sheets, like that. And if you buy this mate, Avery, then you can download a template using this number for free, and you can print yourself with your printer a whole sheet of stickers with whatever words you want on them. If you use these stickers, then the best way to get the words on is to actually stamp the words on. So let's go. Right, so we're going to look at creating this style of sticker. So although I've printed mine out, I've cut them into strips to work on them. So I'm going to use Distress Oxides, but you can use pretty much whatever you like, really. So I'm using Twisted Citron, Peacock Feathers and Wilted Violet. I'm just using makeup sponges and I'm just going to just apply bits of colour around my sticker. Now, the great thing about Distress Oxides, if you dry them between coats, then you're able to layer light colours on top of dark colours. So I'm going to put my light colour on last. So I'm not going to do a little bit of peacock colour. Look at this colour, it's so gorgeous. Now if you don't want to have the texture of the sponge, you need to actually blend with it. So if you don't want this kind of speckly look, you do need to blend with it. So dry it off again. And then last colour. Now you can see that the green is layering over the other colours. And that's some stickers with inks. So for my next set of stamps, I'm going to use a couple of greens, Crepe Pistachio, Peel Paint and Abandoned Coral. And the great thing about Distress Oxides also is they've got a felt pad, so they stamp really well. I wouldn't use Distress inks for this, but it's up to you. So I've got a load of peg stamps that have got different flower motifs on, and some little block stamps. I've got flowers and leaves on. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go around the edges of my stickers. Just add first and second generation stamps, and I'm just going with the flow really. Some more foliage there, and I'm going to take the Crepe Pistachio to line it up a little bit. I'm going to grab another flower, I think. You end up with some really pretty. I can get a bit more green on that one. Oh, I think. You end up with some really pretty stamps. Right, so we're going to colour the background first of all. on this one, so I'm just going to get a blending sponge, and I'm going to do it with the two warm colours, so that's the fossilised amber and the spice marmalade. You could colour the background in with whatever you want, really. So I'm going to put on the lighter colour first, and what I'm trying to do is cover, give it kind of a basic coverage on the sticker. Dry that off. Dries really quickly. And I'm just going to take a stencil and just put through it. And I'm kind of randomly placing the stencil. Don't even mind if we get kind of like this happening. Kind of what I'm doing is just pushing through the colour that's remaining on the stencil. So you get kind of a little shadowy picture. So you could leave it like that. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring in the Seedless Preserve colour. And these are subs from Creatively. Thank you. Then we're going to go for a bit of the blue. So that one needed shaking up. Okay, what goes off here? Yeah, it needed shaking. Just going to wipe off the plate with a piece of tissue. So give it a good shake. Blob on there. Cover the whole plate. So what we can do now is we can go through the stencil, or we can do the other bit. Kind of not ideal. And again, take it off your plate. Never waste anything. Clean your plate off and also clean your stencil off. Even clean your stencil can provide great stuff. And then I'm going to use the last colour, which is the green. Just clean my bow. Any patterns with this, I'm just going to get a general colour on the background of this. Another lift, so we'll get some of it's got dark colour, some of it's got light colour. And then we'll dry that, and then I'll come back and show you what I'll do next. So we're going to stamp some words, and I'm going to use Stays On ink because it pretty much stamps onto anything. I'm using black. I'm going to use some more Creative Bee stamps. This one's Say It. This one's the one I used earlier called Bloom. So I wanted to use the word Rooted. That's why I kept this kit out. Now the only problem is you can't necessarily see where the edge of your sticker is. So sometimes it might be good if you just grab the pencil and just, not on the actual sticker itself, but just on the outside of it so you've got an idea. There we are. There's four in a row here, so you can kind of see just that's what these are. Alright, sorry about that, the doorbell went. So I've marked out where the stickers are so I can see them, and I'm going to pick some words from this Just Say It set. These are tiny, lovely little words. They're not paying me to use their stamps. I just like them, and it's always good to support a UK UK shop or artist. Now I stamped on there first because they're brand new stamps and they have like a little coating on them when you first get them, so it's always best to kind of stamp off onto something, because I haven't got any paper handy, I've just stamped onto my backing paper. There we are, Holy Spirit, And what else should I have? On ink. So this is my red version of the stays on ink. Same thing. Just to contrast against the black thing. And now I can't find the word grace. There it is. So again, this one hasn't been used before, so I'm just stamping it off and then putting it on there like that. And then I'm going to swap colours again. I only have three permanent inks. This is a very fine, but again, it's a print on anything kind of ink, and that one's a brown colour. And I think I'm going to go with Father. Bring back the ones that we let dry earlier. So this is the one, so you've got some kind of little puddles going off there, and now it's dry, but really, really interesting. So what have we created on there? We have those, we have those, 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 and those. You might just have noticed my camera lights come on.